still remember the day when I walked into my audition and I saw this man with his legs crossed with a sickening outfit on and the sleekest haircut you could ever have. And it's such an honor to be standing here just to see how far he has come and to beautifully bring his words to life and to know that his words are prolific and life-changing and beautiful. And I'm sure I can speak for this one right next to me, but has brought our lives to a total different platform. And he is an amazing individual for that, and I'm thankful.
When I look at Stephen Canals, I see a young man standing outside looking in, holding tightly to a script he wrote. Outside that door, he's knocking. All he's got to offer are the words he put on a page. His perspective, his narrative, our people. Only to hear no, again and again and again. For 2 years, Stephen Canals heard no. Oh, but he kept knocking. He kept knocking until he heard his yes. Yes, you may come in now. Yes, you may expand our medium and our industry by giving LGBTQ people of color a foot in the door. And yes, you may evolve our understanding of what it means to be human, to dream, to love, to create family, and above all, how to be your unapologetic self. These are the gifts that Stephen Canals has given us. And so I just want to say thank you, Stephen. Thank you for your work. I know I'm a better man because of it, and I can only hope other people experience the same.
Without further ado, the 2020 New Voice Award of Television goes to Mr. Stephen Canals.
What an honor to be recognized on the same evening as two storytellers who I so deeply admire, Lulu Wang and Quentin Tarantino. See, I was raised in New York City. It was the 1980s, and my South Bronx neighborhood was being ravaged by both the AIDS and crack epidemics. I was a small boy with a big imagination. My mother, Evelyn, a kindergarten teacher, read to me often. I loved the sound of her voice. She'd modulate her tone to give emphasis to happiness or surprise or fear or sadness. Each character in every storybook had their own inflections and pitch and intensity. And all I ever wanted was a voice just like hers. And then I'd head to grade school where my voice was scrutinized. And for 12 years, all I heard was, "Stephen, you sound like a girl. You sound like a sissy. You sound so gay. You sound like a fag." And I hated the sound of my voice, and I quickly learned to silence it. Now, this is a safe space, and I have a true confession to make. My first copy of Final Draft was given to me by my Titi Gigi in 2002, and I didn't install it until August of 2010. So for 8 years, it collected a lot of dust. Now, you can have all of the tools at your disposal, but if you do nothing with them, what does it matter having them? So, why had I not still committed to my goal? I'll tell you why. Because I'm a human, and I'm filled with fear and self-doubt. And the voice in my head that says you aren't smart enough, or you aren't talented enough, you aren't good enough, was very loud. It took years for me to shake off the messaging that there was a problem with my voice. So I committed to lowering the volume of that voice in my head that was constantly undermining me. I was 30 years old, exactly 10 years ago, when I applied to UCLA's professional program in screenwriting. I wrote not one, but two horrible feature scripts that no one will ever read. And that's okay, because I learned a valuable lesson while writing them. See, those characters in those scripts, they spoke to me, and they said, "Get it together." They also said, your voice, both as a verb and as a noun, is enough. You are enough. Stephen, your voice matters. And it is that all-important lesson that I want to imbue in all of my work as a director, as a writer, and as a producer of serialized stories. It permeates every corner of my short film Afuera and my current work on Pose. You see, I want to use my voice to uplift communities and individuals who have a voice that no one listens to. I must use my voice to remind those on the margins that you deserve to be accepted, embraced, loved, and affirmed. And I will use my voice to stand up against racism, sexism, misogyny, classism, homophobia, transphobia, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You see, my voice is my weapon of choice. And until I'm asked to leave, I will continue to use it to create original content that centers diverse voices and moves our industry's needle toward more inclusion and more equity. And I hope that all of you will do the same as allies and as co-conspirators. Thank you, Final Draft, for being one of the tools in my arsenal, and thank you for affirming my voice. Thank you very much.